It is the hit show that had a record-breaking audience of 12 million viewers for its season 4 premiere. And that episode of Duck Dynasty was also the TV debut of the Beardless Brother. Take a look.
During season 4 of the popular hit TV show Duck Dynasty, viewers were introduced to another member of the beloved Robertson family, the oldest son, Alan.
Hey, Al.
What's up, bearded brethren?
Hey.
For whatever reason, our oldest brother, Alan, got away with never growing a beard.
I figured y'all needed a beard wrangler here to whip these boys into shape.
It may be odd to call a pastor the black sheep of the family, but that's what he is.
Alan's been preaching behind a pulpit for years. But now he believes that his church goes beyond brick and mortar.
And now here we are, almost 50.
Joining us now is Alan Robertson. Thank you so much for being here.
Good to be here.
Now, your debut on Duck Dynasty was record-breaking. What do you make of that?
Well, I think it's the beardless bump. I mean, I think that they had been languishing down there around 10 million and finally decided that they needed to go full board, so they brought me on.
Good. Now, as the youngest child, you had the toughest childhood. Tell us about the time that your dad actually threw your mom and brothers out of the house.
Yeah, well, it was all of us, and dad had just decided that we were, you know, basically cramping his lifestyle. And he was not living for the Lord, obviously. He was living for himself. And so he asked us all to leave, and we did. We moved down. We were living about an hour north of where we are now, so we moved down to West Monroe. And like a lot of broken families, we had very little and a difficult time. And so it was very hard on us and hard on the family.
Your dad becomes a Christian. The tables kind of turn. Your parents actually kick you out of the house. What happened?
Yeah, I mean, how does that work, right? We went from him kicking us out to me getting kicked out. But yeah, I don't know if it was like a response maybe to that whole lifestyle, the way it was. But, you know, I just got into those teenage years and kind of went off the pale. And so dad said, look, we got brothers here. You can't live this way and stay here. And so it was tough love. And, you know, now me being a parent, a grandparent, I understand how hard that is. Mm-hmm. But he did the right thing. And I had to learn myself. And so I went out, found my way, and came back home.
Yeah, you essentially went from being the prodigal son to a preacher. It's a big leap of faith.
Absolutely.
What turned your life around? What happened?
You know, I think once I made that decision and I came home, that I wanted to create an atmosphere where other people could come home. And so me as a prodigal, then turned preacher, that's what I wanted. So every Sunday when I preach, I wanted folks to understand that God was welcoming them back. And so I wanted to create an atmosphere like that. So that's been my motivation, really, my entire ministry. And now it's just on a bigger scale. You know, now we're doing it internationally, you know, because of the show.
Wow. And speaking of motivation, you've got a new book. It's called The Duck Commander Devotional. Tell us about that.
Duck Commander Devotional is a daily devotional guide, 365 days. Everybody in the family contributed. So you've got everybody on the show that's in there. We got Godwin and Martin have some devotionals in there, and even Mountain Man. We snuck him in there for one as well. But it's a great read. It's basically a verse, a thought, some way that it impacted us, and then a prayer at the close. So I think it'll be a real encouragement to folks.
Now, you talked earlier about the beardless bump, but now you've got a beard.
Well,
what's going on?
You know, I was calling this the CBN surprise, you know. You guys were expecting me to be all clean shaven, but usually during hunting season, we grow a beard. And they obviously have kept theirs, but I still know where my razor is. I haven't retired it. So at the end of hunting season, I'll probably shave it off and go back to being beardless bro so everybody will know who I am. Right now, I'm totally incognito because they're like, well, we thought he was the black sheep of the family. We don't know who he is now, you know? So that's kind of what I get.
Wow. It really plays out on the show, just the family's faith. Your advice for young people who are big fans and followers about making that decision to follow Christ wholeheartedly.
Well, we say all the time that we don't want them to follow us. Mm. We want them to look at our example and follow Christ. Mm-hmm. And so what I tell young people is, look, no matter where you are, no matter what happens in your life, you can come back from it. You can follow Christ. His grace, His love, His forgiveness, they're so strong and encompassing. There's no place that you can go that's too far. There's no depth too low, no height too high, no place too far away. Mm-hmm. And so no matter what happens, always remember to come home to Christ.
Indeed, indeed. Thank you so much. And Alan's book is called The Duck Commander Devotional. It's available wherever books are sold. We really appreciate your time and
Thank
keep
you
inspiring
much,
us. God bless you.
Appreciate that.